Hey guys, Bobby Hughes here with Heritage Pride Custom Firearms. I'm back to finally bring you the video 9 in the homemade wind turbine power generating battery charging windmill project. And at this point, I am going to give you the walkthrough on the electrical system and all the components that I'm using. Now, it's not exactly the way that I originally planned for it to work, but given the math that I've done and the figuring, the slight engineering, I think it's going to work out just fine, and it should do exactly what we want it to do. Now, before I show you, I want to talk to you a little bit about the motor that we're using. The motor, and I've talked about this in other videos, the motor is actually a old recycled treadmill motor, and it's a permanent magnet DC motor, and when it's spun, it'll produce electricity just like it takes electricity to make it run. It'll work backwards or in reverse polarity. It'll work that way. If you're going to build one of these, I don't recommend getting the motor that I got, because after I did a little bit more research and started engineering a little bit more, what you want to look, my motor actually is 120 volt 7100 RPM motor. In other words, what that means is that it's going to take a lot of wind to produce a lot of power. So ideally what you would want to look for is something in a lower RPM with a higher voltage. So 120 volt, maybe 3600 RPM. Still going to take some wind to charge, but if you think about the RPMs, that's about half. So to take half the wind that mine is going to take to do the same amount of charging. So I recommend actually looking for a lower RPM high voltage motor, and you're going to get better results out of it. Now, as I tested on the bench, and you guys have seen in other videos, it will charge. If we get a good wind going, it'll charge. And even a slow wind, just barely turning it, you're going to get about four to five volts out of it. So what you need to get your 12 volts is a higher spin. Now, if I've done everything right, even with 4 to 5 volts at a low wind speed, turn it, it's still going to charge our battery using the components that we've used. And you don't really have to worry too much about overcharging your battery in this case, because it is such low amp or low voltage. If you had a very low RPM motor that was putting out a lot of voltage, then you would need to install a voltage regulator, but in this case, I don't think we're going to need one. So we're going to bypass the voltage regulator and just go with what's called a bridge rectifier. Basically what that is it allows the current to only flow one way. And in this case, we want it to flow from the generator to the battery, not from the battery to the generator. So I'll show you how to hook that up. And then I got the battery box all complete, so we're going to go ahead and assemble everything, and I'll show you the finished product.
Alright, so here's the bottom part to our battery box, and this is the same frame that I showed me building in an earlier video. And all I did was I found some OSB I had here in the garage and cut it to fit and caulked it up. Now, I kind of questioned myself about using wood. I put a real thick coat of enamel on here so that it'll keep the water off of it better. But let me explain why I used wood. In the winter, it gets really cold here. So if I want to charge a battery in the winter, everybody knows that the cold draws the amperage out of the battery. So if I want to charge a battery, I need it to be halfway warm in here. And since wood is a better insulator than metal, that's why I chose to go with wood for the battery box. It'll keep it a little bit warmer inside and allow it to charge a little bit better. Now what I'm using here, I actually built this box big enough for a full-size battery or a marina type battery, which would be ideal for 12 volt usage and recharge, but in this case I've just got a small lawnmower battery in here just for testing purposes. Okay, so what I've done is, this is our bridge rectifier. You can pick a bridge rectifier up at a Radio Shack for a couple of dollars. They're real cheap, and it's just this little black thing here with little male leads on it, and then we plug our wires into it with our female connectors on there. And the way it's wired up is we have two leads that go from the battery, obviously our positive and our negative. All right, and they run to the bridge rectifier just like that. And then our charging coming from the generator are these two, where I've got female post connectors on here. And then I'll put the male post connectors on the wiring coming down from the generator that we'll go over in just a little bit. That way, when you want to take the battery box off, it's quick and easy. You just unplug the connectors and you can take the whole battery box off of the apparatus, and you don't have to worry about wiring and all that stuff. So the wiring for this will be contained in the box here. The wiring for the generator itself will be contained in the shaft, the center spindle shaft, and the actual vane frame and all that stuff. So it makes a quick disconnect to pull the battery box out. So if we need to change the battery out or anything like that, it's quick and easy. Okay, so that's pretty much it. Now I've also soldered on some gator clips here, and then I've used heat shrink to shrink around, because the covers that come on these are crappy. So I just used some 3/4 inch heat shrink and cut it to fit, and then shrunk it down on there to give us a nice clean look, and it'll last a lot longer. And then I've also heat shrunk all of the connections around the wiring here. So all of that is good to go. So that's the battery box. And then also I'm going to put a little schematic here for you. This is what your bridge rectifier will look like. It'll be square like this. And then you also have your male terminals that are on there will be up and down, up and down, up and down, and then one laid horizontally. All right. So you got three verticals and one horizontal. That'll go up in the top left corner. This is to your battery. So your top left hot goes to your hot lead on your battery, and your bottom right ground goes to your ground on your battery, and then vice versa, going to your coming from your generator. Your hot comes down to the top right, your ground comes down to the bottom left. So there's a schematic for you on how to hook your bridge rectifier up. So I'm going to haul this out to the location of the windmill, and we'll get it wired up and installed, and I'll show you how. All right, guys, so I've got the battery box installed here, and I just want to show you guys. We'll start at the top and work our way down. So we've got the leads that come off of the motor itself. You'll have a red one and a black one, or a hot and a ground, whatever color they are. And then I've ran it to a two-piece trailer extension connector here. And that way, if I need to take the motor off to work on it, I can just unplug this and unbolt these bolts and pull the motor right off. And then I heat shrink that, obviously. And then we've got a grommet with the two wires that come down into the frame of the vane. And then they run back to the center shaft and then drop down and come down through the center shaft and then come out, and it looks like this. And I've got the male post connectors on there. Now I also have this wire here that I ran, and that runs to a little beacon light on top of the vane, a little 12 volt beacon light. I'm not gonna hook that up right now, but if you wanna hook that up, all you have to do is just hook it to the battery and you'll have light. What I might do is put a switch on it so I can turn it on and off if I want to or whatever. Originally, when I designed it, my plan was to put a voltage regulator on this and use that as my indicator light. So if the battery was charging, the light would be off, and when it was done charging, the light would come back on. So that was the plan, but it didn't. Ended up not using a voltage regulator. So anyway, here's our wires that we talked about earlier that come off of the bridge rectifier, hot and ground. All we're going to do with it is just hook the black to the black and the red to the red, so our ground and our positive. And at that point in time, we should be able to produce power from our wind, and it'll charge our battery. So it's pretty much as simple as that. So I will go ahead and get this hooked up, and then I'll probably push the battery to the center to give it a good balance. And then that'll be it for the electrical. I'll put the housing back on the motor there. We got a little bit of wind today, so we might be able to get some movement out of it, so we'll see.